I'm Kendall Roberg, and today we're going to learn about composition of functions. Here we have two functions, f and g. Now, f, in terms of x, is defined as x divided by 4. G, in terms of x, is defined as x cubed. Now, here we have something that's kind of weird, f of g of x. This is called the composition of the function f with the function g. So let's call it a composition function. Now, to figure out what f of g of x is, let's first look at the g of x. G of x is x cubed. So anytime we see g of x, we could instead write x cubed. So we'll do that. Now we have f of x cubed. Now, you may be familiar with figuring out what f of 3 is. For example, if you had to find f of 3, this would mean you simply replace the x with any x on this side. You replace the x with a 3 here, replace the x with a 3 there. So f of 3 is 3/4. But unfortunately, we don't have f of 3. We have f of x cubed. But we're going to do pretty much the same thing. Instead of replacing x with a 3, we're going to replace it with an x cubed. So we have x cubed over 4. So now we're finished. F of g of x is x cubed over 4. Let's look at a different function. Here we have g of f of x. We have our same f and g to start with, but this time we're looking at f of x first. F of x is x over 4, so we could rewrite this as g of x over 4. Now we need to look at the g function. Everywhere we see an x, we need to write a x over 4. So g of x over 4 is x over 4 cubed. Since x was being cubed here, we must now cube x over 4. X over 4 cubed is x cubed over 64. So g of f of x is x cubed over 64. So let's compare g of f of x cubed over 64, to f of g of x, which is x cubed over 4. They're close, but they're different. Good luck.